two micro factors, two macro factors that underlie the trend towards the greater globalization. So these are the two. There are two macro factors, that is a low trade barriers and technological change. Low trade barriers and technological change. So here we'll talk about the low trade barriers. So here we have a main problem was low trade barriers. That is the firm here. If we want to grow, if we want to do a trading between two trading. So here the problem will be there are some barriers were there. That was the low trade barriers. So here with that view that a firm here with a low trade barrier, that firms can view the world and rather than a single country as their market. So here the problem was here if we want to get a more and more profits, we have one of the most problematic thing was it is a low trading. Here we can trade in only one country, but with the globalization effect we can go to another country rather than restrict our trading to only one country. We can go to another country and we can trade to do a trade there also. That is what it is. The firm can view the world. Here the firm can view the world. They can go to another parts of the world, we can go to another countries also. So that is what here they, a businessman can view that thing and rather than a single country as their market. So here I can view market is not in only my country. I can view global markets also. That is what I can do. That is what it gives. It is a low trade barriers. We can remove that barriers. Next, that firms can bear production in optimal location for that activity. So you can get the optimal location for that country. You can get the optimal location for that country. And next, technological change here. The globalization is one of the major thing was it is with the internet it has changed. Actually the global market has come to one place. So definitely these are the with the technological change only the globalization has taken place. It has removed so many barriers and with the technological change only. That is what it helped with the technological change. It helped a lot. Actually with the introduction of internet we can sell our products and services to one country to another country. So that is what it made with the globalization effect. It has made a lot of opportunities to our doorstep. So that is what it made with the technological change only. It was possible. So the microprocessor and telecommunications, with the effect of microprocessors and telecommunications, we can do a communication. We can communicate about our products and services to the other parts of world, other consumers, other parts of markets. So we can increase, we can enhance it. So with the help of this microprocessor sign. Telecommunications. Not only that, as I told, internet and World Wide Web. So with the internet, with the internet facility, we can reach to other parts of world. We can reach to other markets. And not only that, World Wide Web. That is with the website. With the websites, we can reach to the other parts of world, other parts of markets, other parts of customers. So with creating that website, we can communicate with other parts of world also. And transportation technology. So we have our transportation technology has also increased. It also advanced. With the advancement of transportation technology, we can export our goods and services. We can export our products. We can import some raw materials. With that, we can make it into a very good fan. If we If we are in manufacturing industry, we need some raw materials. We can import from other countries. We can import from other countries at low cost, and we can make it a finished product. So that facility is also facilitated with the transportation technology. So it is now transportation technology was increased. So with that also, the technological change is also got greater help towards the globalization. Next, the implications of technological change for the globalization of production include. So the implication of technological change for the globalization of production. When there is a globalization of production, it will include the low transportation cost. So with that, definitely there will be a low transportation cost when technology has advanced. So it has facilitated the low transportation cost, because when the main barrier of any businessman will be the main barrier of commerce, main barrier of trade, the problem was transportation. So this technology advancement has facilitated the low transportation cost. Not only the low information processing and communication, it facilitates to reach the customers with a low communication facility. With that, we can process our trading, buying and selling activity, and we can communicate with the different markets, different other parts of the world. So that is what it facilitated. And not only that, here with this advancement, it is a great help to lot of enterprises. Here there are different types of enterprises are there. With that, they have helped with the technological advancement. And not only that, it has given some of the latest inventions, and it has given the later entrepreneurs also. That is what it helped. And now we are going to learn about the multinational corporations. Multinational corporations that is famously called MNCs. Now we are know what is multinational corporations. So multinational corporations are one of the very important way in underdeveloped countries like us. It has generating lot of employment opportunity. It has giving lot of employment opportunities. Here, with this multinational corporations only, we are getting lot of employment. And not only technology is imported, we can import technology from one country to another. Here the multinational companies are here by its name, we can understand. Here there are two words are there, multi and nation. Multi and nation. So multi means there are two actually. So here a firm which is operating its production activities in one or two countries, then it is regarded as a multinational. Its activities are operating, they are operating in more than one country, then it is regarded as a multinational corporation. So here there are two types. So the name itself tells that multinational means the country, the firm, the business is operating their operations in more than one country, then it is treated as a multinational company. So here different thinkers have given different definitions. So here any company they were doing their operations rather than in home country, they're doing in host countries also. They have to do production operations also. It is not that they are selling their products only, they have to do production operations also. Then they can treat as multinational companies. So that is what the differences of this MNCs. So here it follows that participating in foreign trade, and we can give different names also. It is like a international trade, and we can here it is participating with foreign trade also. So here we can give lot of examples also. And not only that, here there was a survey is conducted by International Labour Organization that here they they observed that the essential of MNCs in the fact that its managerial headquarters, the managerial headquarters are called home country, and where they do the productive business are called as the other countries where they do their activities in other countries, that is called host country. So they are regarded that this as a host country. This is what home country where the managerial headquarters were there, and they don't restrict their activities to only their home country. They will do their activities in host country also. So that is what MNC is. And not only that, they here another Foreign Exchange Regulation Act, FERA Act, that is famously called FERA Act, has also given, FERA Act 1973 has also given the one definition that it is subsidiary companies. Where when the company is there, they have subsidiary, they are operating their business activities in their subsidiary countries, then it is regarded as a multinational companies. The home country is another thing, though when they are doing their business activities in other countries, then they are regarded as a subsidiary countries. So if a US company is there, that is their headquarters, and they are doing business in India. India is a host country. Then they can tell that here they carries a business, otherwise operations in two or more. So here they carries their operations in that host country. So that is what called, that is what the definition they are given by the FERA Act, that is 1973.